where the first ever 6A championship game was played tonight. We had a lot of talent on the field. We had a lot of snow on the field, an absolutely wild one.
I did brush elbows with Emeril, so I don't know if that's going to translate to my kitchen. But besides that, the only cooking I did was out in the heat myself.
All right, Travis, we'll see you later. Thanks.
Dan Mullen has created quite the excitement level here since taking over as head coach at Mississippi State, generating a buzz in Starkville with Ole Miss taking a huge win over Texas Tech in the Cotton Bowl, 47-34. In Dallas with the Rebels, Travis Raycheck, Fox 40 Sports.
Got a lot of help, though, coming from his quarterback in Antoine Wilson, who's combined for over 2,500 total yards, 28 touchdowns. Those two guys, big time.
Comeback stories in sports can be inspiring. Comeback stories that take four decades to complete, pretty much unheard of, until you meet this Holmes Community College kicker.
He gets ready like a normal football player, but Alan Moore is not like every other guy on the team.
It's a lot different than it was in 68.
As in 1968. Yes, that was the last time Alan Moore played football. Now, it was about this time a year ago that the Taylorsville native spawned an idea to make an improbable comeback.
I went outside, started kicking, bought a practice tee. It took me about 8 weeks to get one up off the ground. It's the first time I touched football in 42 years.
The obvious rust wore off and persistence paid off after many colleges turned him away. But Holmes provided Moore one more chance.
It's a great story of perseverance and then making up your mind you're going to make a commitment to something and working it. And no matter how many times you fail, you keep trying because we weren't the first place he came.
Trying to do this thing that it wasn't like a me thing. It had to be a we thing. I wanted the team to accept me, the coaches to accept me, and the institution to accept it. And I think that they've all done that. The kids have been awesome. Couldn't say it any different.
Moore made this team based on his kicking ability. Now, he hasn't played in any of the Bulldogs' three games this season, but when and if he does, he'll be the oldest player on record at the JUCO level, and he'll be ready.
My time will come. Whenever everything's right.
An inconceivable idea to most has turned into his life's mission.
It wasn't if I was going to kick somewhere in the state of Mississippi, it was where I was going to kick. I'll keep to that commitment to the very last second of the very last game. It's been life-changing. It's changed lives, changed things around, the way I think, the way I do things.
And now Moore's next chance at making some history, getting in a game, will be Thursday. Holmes will host Northeast Mississippi Community College.
One is the top center in the state and signed to play basketball next year at Georgetown. The other, a highly rated junior recruit set to make his mark in football. Together, these brothers form a famous family.
They're kooky, mysterious and spooky. They're all together ooky, the Addams Family. Their house is a museum, when people come to see them, they really are a scream, the Addams Family.
It's all about competing, you know. Like if I have a bad game, he'll mess with me. And if he have a bad game in football, I'll mess with him. So, you know, don't nobody want to get picked on.
We argue a lot sometimes. We have a lot of disagreements, but it's good. He way hard on me. I ain't that hard on him. We used to fight all the time when we lose.
When we were little, you know, we always fought.
We just hate to lose to each other in basketball and video games.
Like, if we played video games, we fought. Played in the backyard, we fought. Went to the park, we fought. So it was all fun and games. I think it'd be hard a little bit, but I think me and him both would be okay.
It's going to be hard. Probably going to miss him a lot when he's gone.
The Addams Family.
And, there's another brother who's in the eighth grade, already on the varsity basketball team. Big game for the Addams Family tomorrow. Brandon hosts top-ranked Meridian.
40 Sports.
If you want to compete for championships, love the opportunity to compete for championships. I'll be in some championship games come November. Has the opportunity to compete for championships. I believe they're going to have the opportunity to win championships on a team that has championship caliber.
When talking to Dan Mullen yesterday, it was hard to get a read on what he was thinking about. Or maybe it wasn't. The company line at Mississippi State is clear. Championships. Or is it championships? Yeah, he mentioned the phrase six times in a three-minute span. But it's obviously something he believes this team can achieve. They sit at 4-0, entering the bye week, and have a very favorable schedule to set up some huge games come November. It's talking about premier national matchups against the likes of Alabama and LSU.
We'll see as October goes through. If we get through October unscathed, I think we'll put ourselves in a position to play for champion, you know, be in some championship games come November. And that's where you want to be as a football program.
Remember the last team that actually played for a championship in the state? That was Southern Miss a year ago. Oh, how things aren't the same at Southern right now. The Golden Eagles still looking for their first win this season. They'll do so back at home Saturday night against 19th-ranked Louisville. That's a former Conference USA foe. Now, USM will also have to pull the upset off with possibly their third-string QB. Both Chris Campbell and Anthony Alford left Saturday with injuries, leaving Ricky Lloyd, who actually played fairly well.
There's never been a lot of separation in the three. They've all been decent. They've all had their problems. They're three quarterbacks who've never taken a snap in a college football game before this season. I'm saying all that to say this. We got complete confidence in Ricky Lloyd.
Is tonight their night? The Braves close to clinching a spot in the postseason, could make it happen at home against Miami. Atlanta down a run, bottom nine. Rally caps in place as the retiring Chipper Jones leads the inning off. Chip laces a double to the alley, so that'll put him in scoring position to tie the game up. But you know what? Forget about that. The next man up is Freddie Freeman. He takes care of it.
Fly ball belted, center field deep.
The Braves beat the Marlins 4-3, clinching a spot at the very least as a wild card team. The champagne flowing, and so are the emotions for Chipper. And this is last hurrah.
Well, it makes it all worth it. You know, I'm happier for these guys. Ah, that's cold. I'm happier for these guys because they worked hard.
That's awesome right there. Doesn't get much better for that. Congrats to the Braves, and keep it here. More news in a minute.